Hi, horsey people. Man, I got so much hate from the UK because I cracked on a queen and their non-horse riding ability, and all the people came out in droves from UK saying Americans don't know what we're talking about, and these horses are loved and great and cared for, and a queen loves them and great. Now, there's this video here that says, "Don't mess with the Queen's royal." How to ride a horse, really? Let's take a look at this poor horse, and I want you to watch this horse here. Chains, I always say chains, metal, everything negative shows lack of horsemanship. These bits they're using, very large, long shanks with ports inside. When you pull on the bottom, it forces a piece on top that pushes up on the horse's mouth, and it also pushes a piece on the bottom that pushes down and drives it into the tongue. If the horse is able to get his tongue over it, then it drives it into the bottom of the mouth. So large metal bits may look nice and flashy and changy, and oh, look at the pretty silver and the flashy gloves and the flashy hats and the flashy headband and the flashy bit. But in reality, usually flash is pain and cruelty and lack of knowledge to the horse. I want you to watch this horse's mouth and tongue and uncomfortableness as this video goes on. Look at the hand. Look at the hand of the rider. Horse's mouth. Now, I have this on fast motion. I will show it on regular motion so you can see what it is. And then, because of the length of the video and the continued harassment by this guy, watch the checking. You'll hear this a lot, this term, seesawing the bit or checking the horse. Watch this yank of the wrist. It doesn't see to the naked eye, it doesn't look like he's moving a whole bunch. He's moving his hand 2 or 3 inches to the rear. But 2 or 3 inches on a large leveraged shank bit creates an enormous amount of pressure, causes the tongue to hang out. It deforms the tongue. I did a horse on a video where a horse always hangs her tongue out, and everybody, that's so cute. She sticks her tongue out. It's not cute. She's been abused by a bit, and it's done nerve damage to the tongue that the poor horse can't even keep his tongue in his mouth. So, I mean, and again, I'm going to get idiots here saying that, oh, well, a rope across the nose is just as bad as a bit. Are you crazy? I mean, how can some idiot realize shank, leverage, torquing? Again, the hand movement will look very short, very quick, and jerky, but it creates an enormous amount of torque. You'll notice the horse's head is able to bend. If you can bend a horse's head by just moving your hand by an inch, you're creating a lot of pain and torque to get that horse to give that pressure. Because this horse isn't giving because he's trained. He's giving because he's in pain. Yeah, this horse is just having a great time. Pulling. Ouch. Horse looking for ouch, ouch. Watch the hand. Horse is in pain. Ouch, 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 ouch. I want you to notice, I'm gonna go back here a little bit, how the bit is straight up and down when it's loose. See how it's at this angle? That's pressure and pain. That means the top of this bit is driving into the roof and the bottom is driving into the tongue. When the bit is straight with the mouth, there's no pressure. It's still uncomfortable. The horse still doesn't like it and he knows pressure's about to come. But you notice this angle compared to this angle. Now watch as this goes through here. Right there. Let me go back. Darn it. I'm having a hard time getting this right to where I want it to stop. You see how the horse bows his head and moves back to release the pressure, and the bit goes vertical up and down? So there's less pressure on the roof of the mouth and there's less pressure on the bottom. But that doesn't last long. Watch this bit. It stays this way versus this way. Ow, 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 ow. A lot of torque. Yeah, these horses just have great lives. Horse is looking for release. He's trying his tongue. He's like, hey, this thing is hurting. Idiots will tell you when a horse foams that it's good and the horse likes it. That's just stupid. This horse is not comfortable. You know, people will say, oh, that's because, Rick, it's a sweet bit and the horse likes to play with it. You're just an idiot. So I want you to look at this. The bit is less pressure. The horse is trying to get his tongue around. He's trying to get the bit out of his mouth. And, you know, when a horse is like this, it could be a clue that the bit's too tight. They've got this so tight because they're going to say the horse is hard-headed and he won't stand still. And I need a tight Rick to make him listen. And you should have three wrinkles here. If you got any wrinkles at all, your bit's too damn tight. That means you're yanking it into the horse's. You're grinding it into the back of the horse's mouth. But there's still idiots out there that teach all this. Three wrinkles, tight, your bit's too loose, the bit needs to be tighter, you need a bigger feel-good bit, you need a sweet bit, you need a soft bit, you need a rubber bit. You don't need anything in a horse's mouth. If you do, you don't know what you're doing. You're hurting a horse, you're using pain compliance. That's all a bit is. It's create pain. It's to give the rider leverage so he has to do less to create pain. This rider can overpower the horse by moving his hand 4 to 5 inches and create so much pain that the horse has to listen. That's not horsemanship, people. I'm going to speed this up because it goes so long. And then you can watch the horse's mouth. And then tell me how much the horse loves it. Yanking on the bit. Watch the rider yank. Pawing. A horse is looking for release. Ow, it hurts. I'm uncomfortable. Chain. Chains on a horse's. That's good to keep his head down. We need a lot of chains. More silver. More chain. Let's make it look pretty, even though the horse is not, you know, comfortable at all. Pain. Look at the bit. Watch that bit tighten up. Watch it go vertical or horizontal instead of vertical. Watch the checking. Watch the little jab with the boot and the spur. Yeah, well, all you UK people that want to come here and cry, why are you picking on the queen? Why do you, these horses are loved. These horses have great lives. You don't know what you're talking about. That horse loves the bit. Chains are good for horses and metal in their mouth yanking and the horse is playing because he loves it. And you freaking idiots, are you kidding me? You can't tell the discomfort and pain in this horse? Wow, they put their swords in really fast. That's really great. Wow, look how happy that horse is. Wow, slap the horse. That'll show him. Wow, slap him again. Wow. That's training. To beat a queen's horse, you have to learn how to slap a horse. Are you serious? Come on, people. Pull your head out. There are none so blind as those that refuse to see. People want to come here and see what they want to see and hate on the truth. If you want to argue about something, argue about what I said that ain't true with these horses. Okay? Don't come here just claiming that Americans are stupid and the UK's great and we love our horses and the queen's wonderful and whatever. These horses are not, they don't need those bits to stand there for 5 minutes. I get my horse standing there with a loop around his neck without even anything on his face because I understand a horse and I don't have to use pain and torture devices and archaic metal leverage pain bits. All right, we'll end that there.